अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन स्टूडेंट्स। वी आर इन यूनिट 5 दैट इज कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग एंड इन टुडेज लेसन वी विल डिस्कस असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर एंड इट्स यूज एंड फर्दर वी विल डिस्कस रिलेशनल ऑपरेटर्स। फर्स्ट असाइनमेंट ऑपरेटर, द सेम इक्वल टू दैट वी यूज इन मैथमेटिक्स बट इन प्रोग्रामिंग इट इज कॉल्ड assignment operator because it is used to assign value to a variable. So the assignment operator is used to assign a numeric value or string value to a variable. The reserved word let may be used in assignment operator. Whenever we are using assignment operator, so at that time we may use the let reserved word which is used for declaring a variable. It has the following syntax: line number, which is inserted most of the time automatically by the IDE, then the reserve word let, and then variable name is equal to means the assignment operator, and then it depends on our requirement and the program whether we are assigning constant value to a variable or we are assigning another variable to this variable, or we are assigning an expression. Expression is actually a combination of operators and operands, or combination of constants and variables, combination of constants or just variables. Expression is a combination of multiple values in the form of constants or variables, so that can also be assigned to a variable. So this is the general syntax for using assignment operator. A few examples of assignment statements are given below. Let roll number and assignment operator 101. What does it mean? That roll number r dot number, it's a variable name, and the value which is assigned inside this variable, that is 101. The value which is stored in this variable is 101, and this is just because of this assignment operator. Without this assignment operator, we cannot assign any value to this variable. Another example, let n and this dollar sign. I told you that whenever there is a dollar sign at the end of any variable name, that variable will be considered as a string variable. So n is a string variable, and we are assigning this string value inside this variable with the help of this assignment operator. Sumna, it's a name of a girl, and enclosed in double quotation mark, because we are assigning a string value, so a string must be enclosed in double quotation marks. Third example, let sum is equal to a plus b plus c. As I told you that you can assign an expression. Now here a, b, c, these are variables, and their sum is assigned to this variable sum with the help of assignment operator. The reserve word let is optional to use. In some cases the let keyword or reserve word is optional to use. The assignment operator, this one, equal to, is sufficient for assigning values to variable names. So assignment operator is used for assigning values to variables. Here we have some examples which are given in your book. You will see these examples. Example number 1 says that write a basic program to add two numbers, and the numbers are 5 and 6. We have got two numbers 5 and 6, and we have to calculate the sum of these two numbers. First, we need a variable, let a. A is a variable, it will contain the first value, that is 5. So with the help of assignment operator, we are assigning this value to variable a. Another variable that we will declare, let b. You can assign any names to these variables instead of a and b. These are it's your choice to assign any name for variables. but here we are using a and b as variable names. A contains value 5 and b contains value 6, and those values are assigned with the help of assignment operators. The third variable that we need, that is sum, which will contain the sum of a and b, and that value will be assigned with the help of this assignment operator to this variable sum. Now we want to print the value of sum. Print, this print statement is an output statement which will print the value on the output screen. First it will display the message sum is equal to, and in front of that the value of this variable sum will be printed, and then the program ends. Whenever we execute these 5 lines of code, this output is going to be generated. When we run this program, the output will be sum is equal to 11. As we know that when 5 is added with 6, the result will be 11, and 11 is stored inside this sum. Then in the print command, we print the sum and equal to, which is enclosed in double quotation mark as it is, and then the value of sum is displayed, which is 11. Here we have calculated the value of sum, which is actually the sum of a and b, that is 11. It will be printed. Example 2. Write a basic program to swap two values. The values are 5 and 6. We have two values inside two different variables. We have to swap the values of those two variables. Like here, first we will take a variable, let a is equal to 5 and let b is equal to 6. Now what we need to do, we have to swap the values of a and b, so that the b will have the value 5 and a will have the value 6. This is called swapping values. For this purpose we will need a third variable, let c, and c is assigned with the value of a. Whatever the value of a, we just have to assign the variable a to variable c. So automatically the value 5 is stored inside c. Now we can change the value of a, because we have already stored the value of a inside c for future use. Let a is equal to b. The value of a, which is 5, is already assigned to c. Now we can replace the value of a, that is 5, with the value of b, which is 6. So a is equal to b. It means that the value of b is 6, and 6 is assigned to a. Now we have to assign the value of a, which was 5, to b, but that value is already stored inside c. So we will simply write let b is equal to c, because c contains the old value of a, which was 5. So this is how the value will be swapped. So b is assigned with c, which contains the old value of a, that is 5. Now after this, when we print the values of a and b, we will see that the values are swapped. Print a is equal to, it will be printed as it, because it is enclosed in double quotation mark, and then the value of a will be printed. This semicolon gives you a single space. A is equal to 6. The first print statement is executed, and the result is a is equal to 6. In the beginning, the 6 was the value of b, but now it is swapped, so a is having the value 6 and b is having the value 5. When it is print in this statement, b is equal to and the value of b, so it is 5. So this is how you can swap the values of two variables with each other. Relational operators. The relational operators are used to form conditions. These operators allow us to compare two values to check whether they are equal, unequal, or whether one is greater than the other, or vice versa. Sometimes we write such programs in which we want to make some decisions, or we write some conditional statements. So for that purpose we need relational operators. conditional statements are those which results either in true or false. These relation operators are less than, greater than, equal to, and this one is less than or equal to. Less than or equal, it can be written either in this form or in this form. This one is greater than equal to, it can be written in these two forms, greater than or equal to. This one is not equal to, you can write it either in this form or in this form, but it means not equal to. So these are relational operators. In the coming lessons we will solve such programs where we will be using the relational operators, but now in the next slide I will demonstrate that how the previous example programs can be written in the basic IDE and how we can execute them. So don't forget to watch that video. Okay, now we are going to demonstrate these two programs practically in the basic IDE. I will upload this software for all of you in the Google Classroom. You can download this software in the form of folder and then you can practice these programs at your home on your computers or laptops. This is the application QB64. This is the IDE of basic language, basic programming language. This blue screen is called editor. Here you can type your programs. Now, the first example in your book, which was adding two numbers. So, let me see that example from the book so that it can be as it is as given in the book. Now, you don't need to assign the line numbers here because this is the advanced editor of basic language. It will assign the line numbers automatically. Just write the program. Let a is equal to 5. We were having two values. It will automatically capitalize the reserved words. Then let b is equal to 6. Then we had the sum variable. Let sum is equal to a plus b. These are the three variables that we required. Then we will print the value of sum. Print sum is equal to inverted commas closed. Then we will put a semicolon and variable sum so that the value of sum will be printed when we run this program. And then write end. Once you have written this program, go to the run command and here you can click on the start. Further, you can also use the shortcut key, that is F5. So when I click on the start button, you have to wait for a while because it is creating the exe file. Now the exe file is created and the output is shown. Sum is equal to 11. So this is the output of this program. It shows the message sum is equal to 11. It has added these two values 5 and 6 and stored inside the variable sum, and by the help of this print statement we are producing this output. Sum is equal to the value of sum, 11. Okay, now let's have a look of the second example where we were swapping the values of a and b, that is 5 and 6. We'll edit the same program. The value of a is 5 and the value of b is 6. I told you we need a third variable, variable c, and it will contain the value of a. Capital, then write let now the a of, the value of a is assigned to c, so we can change the value of a easily. A is equal to b, and the value of b can also be changed by assigning the value of c, which actually contains the old value of a. Okay. Now we will print the values of a to see whether they are swapped or not. Print a semicolon and a. Print semicolon b and b. Now our program is complete. Now we will see the output, whether the values are swapped or not. Go to the run command or just press F5. See, the program in the beginning, the value of a was 5, but here now it is swapped and a is having the value of b, which is 6, and b is having the value of 5, which was 5. B is having the value of a, that is 5. So it means that the values are swapped. So this is how you can write program in the basic IDE, and you can execute it by using the run command. Under the run menu, you can press on the start button, or you can just press the F5 key and produce, or it will show the output on the console screen. That black screen, this black screen is called console. So it will show you the output in this one. Okay students, I hope you have got the concept clearly. So that's it for today. You should practice these programs at your home. Thanks a lot. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Okay students, that's it for today. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe my channel Computer Tuition Academy. Thanks a lot. Take care. Allah Hafiz.